This is a song that the Lord wrote to me. Don't hang, Keith, you're an egomaniac thinking God's going to write you a song. He's got better things to do keeping the moon in orbit. I mean, it's going to take time to sit down at the piano and write you a song. You nuts. Say, well, I was really in need, you know, and I'm his little kid. And he wanted to please me. I mean, which one of you parents, if you had a two-year-old daughter and lost her little nickel, you know, would go up to him and go, it's only a nickel. I mean, you know. Go, oh, the baby lost a nickel. Oh. Right? But we're God's little kids. He cares about our lost nickels compared to his universes. He's the God of the small and the great. You don't have to, you know, to get a healing from God, you don't have to, he's not like Marcus Welby. You don't need to have cancer, you know, for him to come to your house. So many people go to the Lord and go, God, you know, I've only got a cold. I'm going to save up for something real big, you know, before I ask you for a healing. And that's not the way we should come to the Lord. So I came to the Lord one day going, God, I haven't written a song in 2 months. He goes, aw. So he wrote me one. My son, why are you striving? You can't add one thing to what's been done for you. I did it all while I was dying. Rest in your faith, my peace will come to you. For when I hear the praises start, oh, I want to rain upon you blessings that will fill your heart. I see no stain upon you because you are my child and you know me. To me, you're only holy. Nothing that you've done remains, only what you do for me. My child, why are you weeping? You will not have to wait forever. That day and that hour is in my keeping. The day I'll bring you into heaven. For when I hear the praises start, my child, I want to rain upon you blessings that will fill your heart. Oh, I see no stain upon you because you are my child and you know me. But to me, you're only holy. Nothing that you've done remains, only what you do for me, only what you do in me. So many things that you've been hearing, but you just hold on to what I have told you. When I hear the praises start, my bride, I want to rain upon you blessings that will fill your heart. Oh, I see no stain upon you know me. Well, to me, you're only holy. Nothing that you've done
will remain. Only what you do for me. Only what you do for me. Only what you do in me. Only what you do for me.
Glory, and all the holy angels with him. Then shall he sit on his glorious throne, and he shall divide the nations before him, as the shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he shall put the sheep on his right, and the goats on his left. Shall say to those on his right, the sheep, come ye, blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom before prepared for you before the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was naked, and you clothed me. Oh, I was sick, and you visited me. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. Oh, I was in prison, and I waited for you, and you came to me. Thank you. Something to eat, or when were you thirsty and we gave you something to drink? Lord, I can't remember that. When were you naked and we clothed you? Lord, when were you a stranger and we invited you in? I mean, Lord, we invited lots of people in, but we can't remember seeing you there. Well, when were you sick or in prison and we visited you? I mean, we went to lots of prisons, Lord. We never saw you there. I mean, we knew you were there, but we never saw you. Lord, when? Inasmuch as you've done it to the least of my brethren, you've done it unto me. Oh, yes. Inasmuch as you've done it to the very least of my brethren, you've done it unto me. Enter into your rest. Shall turn to those on his left, the goats. Depart from me, you cursed ones, into everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me nothing to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was naked, and you never clothed me. I was a stranger, and I knocked, and I not, but you told me to go away. I was sick, and I was lying there in pain, and I waited for you, but you never came. I was in prison, and I rotted there, waiting for you. But I guess you had more important things to do. Depart from me, you cursed one. Lord, there must be some mistake. Lord, when? Lord, when were you hungry or thirsty, Lord, and we didn't give you something? I mean, Lord, would you like something now? Wouldn't you angels go out and get the Lord a hamburger and a Coke or something? You're not hungry, Lord. Oh, well, Lord, when were you naked and we didn't clothe you? I mean, we didn't even have your chest size, Lord. That's not fair. But Lord, this is something I gotta know. When were you a stranger, Lord, and we didn't invite you in? I mean, we looked out the window every time, Lord. There were a lot of weirdos and creeps out there. I mean, Lord, that just wasn't our ministry. You know what I mean? You didn't want us to cast our pearls before swine, did you? Oh, now, come on, Lord. When were you sick? I mean, how could the Lord get sick? What did you have, anyway? Or in prison? I mean, you were in prison? What were you in for? As you have not done it to the least of my brethren, you have not done it unto me. That's all there is to it. Inasmuch as you've not done it to the very least of my brethren, you've not done it unto me. And these shall go away into everlasting fire, but the righteous into everlasting life. My friend, the only difference between these two groups of people, according to these scriptures, is what they did and didn't do.
Seaside, sunset, silver lining round the clouds. Yeah.
But you've been working on heaven, Jesus. You've been working on heaven, Holy Spirit. You've been working on heaven 2,000 years. La 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 la.
Conquered death. This song is called, So You Wanna Go Back to Egypt. And the whole message tonight is about, could God do to us what he did to the Israelites? It's kind of hard to, the new Israelis, you know, they call them Israelites in the Bible. Here we are, Santa Rosaites up here. And stalagmites hanging from the ceiling. This is about this whole message that the Lord has given me tonight, that I believe the Lord's given me. If he hasn't, we're all in trouble. Could God do to us what he did to them? Or, here's another working title. Has God changed? What does the Bible say? Can God change?
No.
Amen. God does not change. Only the contract changed. Only the covenant. God didn't change. The testaments changed. The covenant changed. It's kind of like he saw how few people were getting in under the old contract, so he renegotiated a new contract. Because a lot of us dumbos just couldn't get in under the old one. You know what I mean? But God has some principles that still operate today. Thank God. And this song is called, So You Want to Go Back to Egypt. It's about a bunch of people called the children of Israel that were captive in Egypt. And God worked an incredible amount of miracles to get them out. It was Plague City in Cairo. And Sadat would have dropped his teeth if he was around then. And when God got them out of Egypt, after a few days, they started bellyaching. What are we going to do for water? Did God bring us out here to make us die of thirst? He goes, no, he gets you water out of this little stand here with a rock. You know, just hit the rock, out comes water. So anyway, God sent them manna. What's the manna? Manna is this stuff that comes out of the sky and falls with the dew, and it was kind of like, well, it's kind of like Wonder Bread. You know what I mean? And they kind of got sick and tired after a few decades. You know, they didn't like the stuff. So they complained, and finally they gave God the ultimate insult.
Boy, we sure had it better back in Egypt, man. Hey, man, we used to have jumbo jacks with garlic and onions.
And I hope they had Lavoris, too. This is all called, So You Want to Go Back to Egypt. Listen, this is not just a comedy about Israelites and Egyptians. This is about you and I, the people of God in a world called Egypt or spiritual Sodom. Figure that one out. How can you possibly clap and hear the lyrics too, yeah? I left my drummer home because he played too loud.
Well, you wanna go back to Egypt, where it's warm and secure. I am sorry you bought the one-way ticket when you thought you were sure. You wanted to live in the land of promise, but now it's getting so hard. I am sorry you're out here in the desert instead of your own backyard. Eating leeks and onions by the Nile. Ooh, what breath, but dining out in style. Travel, and we sure travel a lot, 'cause it's hard to keep your feet from moving when the sand gets so hot. And in the morning it's manna hotcakes, we snack on manna all day. And they sure had a winner last night for dinner, flaming manna souffle. Well, we once complained
Egypt, where your friends wait for you. You can throw a big party and tell the whole gang that what they said was all true. And this Moses acts like a big shot. Who do he think he is? Yeah, it's true that God works lots of miracles, but Moses thinks they're all his. Well, I'm having so much trouble even now. Why'd he get so mad about that cow, that golden cow? Moses seems rather idle. He just sits around. He just sits around and writes the Bible. Oh, Moses, put down your pen. What? Oh, no. Mammy again? My heart is hard, my heart is hard. My prayers are cold, and I know how, and I know how I ought to be. I ought to be alive to you, alive to you, and dead to me. And dead to me. What can be done for an old heart like mine? Sing it. What can be done for an old heart like mine? Soften it up with oil and wine, with oil and wine. The oil is you, the oil is you. Your spirit of love, your spirit of love. Please wash me anew, please wash me anew. In the wine, in the wine. Before the Lord, make it a prayer to the Lord. If you find that sometimes in your prayer time you can't pray, then you ought to start praying about not being able to pray. If you go before the Lord and the ceilings are brass, then start telling the Lord, Lord, this is my prayer. I can't pray. Help. My eyes are dry. My faith is old. My heart is hard. My prayers are cold. And Lord, I know how I ought to be alive to you and dead to me. Sing it to him. My eyes are dry. My eyes are dry. My faith is old. My heart is hard. My prayer. And I know how I ought to be alive to you and dead to me. What can be done for an old heart like mine? What can be done for an old heart like mine? Soften it up with oil. Wash me anew, please wash me anew, in the wine of your blood, in the wine of your blood.
This next song is, it's definitely a song. It's interesting. Do you know, a lot of Christians feel like if they give their once a week to the Lord, they're doing real well, especially if they go every week. It's kind of like visiting a friend in jail, you know, like once a week. On Sundays, you know, visiting hours. Hi, Lord. How are you doing, Lord? Are they treating you okay in here? Is the food all right, Lord? We're working on getting you out soon. You know, and then I'll never forget the first... I'll never forget the first time I wrote out my first tithe check. It was kind of like... And Satan came and told me, you still got 90% left. I went, yeah, 90% for me. The Lord goes, for who? Oh, hi, Lord. Well, that's kind of a joint account. Tell you what, I won't make any heavenly decisions. You don't spend any of my money. But you see, I was sitting around one day. I had this melody, and I just taught a Bible study on, remember Saul, king in the Old Testament? God told him to do something, and he did half of it. Patted himself on the back and gave the other half to the Lord as a sacrifice. The Lord said, I don't want your sacrifice, I want your obedience.
I don't need your money, I want your life. And I hear you say that I'm coming back soon, but you act like I'll never return. Well, you speak of grace and my love so sweet, how you thrive on milk but reject my meat. And I can't help weeping at how it will be if you keep on ignoring my word. Prosper and succeed, but your flesh is something I just can't feed. I want more than Sundays and Wednesday nights. 'Cause if you can't come to me every day, then don't bother coming. According
what you have done. According to what you have done. According to what you have done.
I wrote this song, and it's called Dear John Litter to the Devil. Y'all know what a Dear John Litter is? It's what a wife or a girlfriend or a reasonable facsimile would write home to her husband or boyfriend or reasonable, whatever. And, you know, it would say in the letter just very shortly, you know, get captured, you know, or something like that. And the Lord wanted me to write off Beelzebub. Completely, right, the dude off, right? So I wrote this song, and it kind of describes how we were once bosom buddies, and how now we're arch enemy. Oh, I used to love you, but now that's hard to do, 'cause I got some information about them evil things at night that you do. Now the whole thing is through. Oh, you're such a devil. How'd you get me to believe you were true? Ooh. Oh, my daddy warned me, and how my mama cried the day I left my home. You said you'd always keep me satisfied. But oh, how you lied, you lied. Well, I should have heard my mama's words, but then I guess I had too much pride. Original sin. Whoa, I used to lie awake at night and see your face on the ceiling. Oh, what a bad feel I have when I think of how you almost got me in the ways of the world. Ouch. My so-called friends say I've misjudged you. My anger's all in vain. But I'm afraid you got to them before I had a chance to explain, you creep. And it caused me such pain. Oh, 'cause they were such good friends of mine, but now you've got them playing your game. Whoa, I used to lie awake at night and see your face on the ceiling. Oh, what a bad feeling I have when I think of how you almost got me in the ways of the world, in the ways of the world. Oh, in the ways of the world, in the ways of the world. Take it on and 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 on. Still cheaper than a guitar player. Jesus and what he said he's gonna do. He'll put an apple in your lying mouth, cook you in a sulfur stew. One that'll never be through. Oh yeah, oh, but if he hadn't rescued me, then I'd be down there cooking too. Oh, if Jesus hadn't rescued me, then I'd be cooking right next to you. Oh, I used to lie awake at night and see your face on the ceiling. What a great feeling I have when I think of how you're gonna get yours at the end of the world, at the end of the world. Oh, at the end of the world, at the end of the world. Oh, at the end of the world. Na 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 na. Yeah. The Lord. All right. All right.
Open your eyes to the world all around you. Open your eyes, open your eyes. This world is much more than the things that surround you. You must arise and open your eyes. Sometimes we're too busy to share, but Jesus wants us to care, care. Open your arms to the naked and shivering. Open your arms, open your arms. We need a little less taking, a whole lot more giving. We're so safe and warm, we can open our arms and love a little bit stronger and pray a little bit longer, longer. Oh, Jesus says if we love someone in his name, we're loving him. Jesus says if we touch someone in his name, we're touching him. And we need to show them the light, and we've got to pour out our lives, our lives. Well, open your hearts to the ones who are desperate. Open your hearts, open your hearts. They may never repay you, but their souls are worth it, but their souls are worth it. Just open your heart. Jesus loves all men the same. So we've got to go out in his name, his name. Oh, Jesus says if we love someone in his name, we're loving him. Jesus says if we touch someone in his name, we're touching him. Jesus says if we feed someone in his name, we're feeding him. Listen, Jesus says it's him. Open your eyes to the world all around you. Open your eyes, open your eyes. So many times I've tried to tell you, but I don't think you've been listening. There's nothing I want to try and sell you, 'cause his love is free. You're so proud of saying you're a seeker, but why are you searching in the dark? You won't learn a thing until you soften your heart. Message is oh so very simple. You gotta be like a child to see, 'cause Jesus said, let those little children come unto me. You try to make things too complicated, but you really don't have to be so smart. I know you won't learn a thing until you soften your heart. La, la, la. Show you your empty life, I know you would follow him right now. Well, I know it sounds just too good to be true, but if it lives in you, you'll never die, you'll never die, you'll live forever. You'll never die, you'll never die, take care of forever now. Tell everyone to keep on smiling. Your outlook on life is so positive. but deep down inside, you're searching for a reason to live. Like everyone else, you're scared of dying, but the power of death has been blown apart, and you live forever. If you soften your
with a song that the Lord gave my wife. It's really neat to sing your wife's song.
Make my life a prayer to you. I want to do what you want me to. No empty words and no white lies. No token prayers, no compromise. I want to shine the light you gave through your Son you sent to save us from ourselves and our despair. It comforts me to know you're really there. I want to thank you now for being patient with me. Oh, it's so hard to see when my eyes are on me. I guess I'll have to trust and just believe what you say. Oh, you're coming again, coming to take me away. The love that set me free. I want to tell the world out there you're not some fable or fairy tale that I've made up inside my head. You're God, the Son, you've risen from the dead. With me, oh, it's so hard to see when my eyes are on me. I guess I'll have to trust and just believe what you say. Oh, you're coming again, coming to take me away. Share the love that set me free.
Billy Ray asked me to close. Go ahead and be seated. I'm just going to preach for a few hours. I promise you're going to bed. I mean, you're going to see the witness. Just in closing, make it easier for Jesus to come back this next year by living the life he asked you to live so that others don't have to make excuses for the reason for what make excuses why Christians don't live the way Jesus asked them to. Let's just bow our heads and ask the Lord to pour out his Spirit on us as we leave. Lord Jesus, we come before you nothing but vessels made out of dust, Lord, that's held together by your Holy Spirit. We realize that we move and have our being in you. There's nothing we can do on our own. We're helpless creatures without you. And in you, Lord, we're more than conquerors. Lord Jesus, help us conquer the hypocrisy around us. And help us conquer the hypocrisy right inside of us through your Spirit and through the blood you shed. And as we go, Jesus, let us realize that the word Christian means little Christ, and we're supposed to be little Jesuses walking around by your grace. And in Jesus' name, we ask that you let that be in our lives in the next few days, the next few years, so that when you come back, we won't be ashamed at your appearing. In Jesus' name, amen. Go in peace. Thank you.